And first at 6, on this day set aside for honoring mothers, some moms are mourning the loved ones they've lost.
Today, a group of mothers marched through Dayton to remember sons and daughters killed by gun violence. 2 News reporter Robert Lowry live downtown with their message.
Mark and Katie, it was a somewhat somber Mother's Day for a few families who met here at Courthouse Square this afternoon. After walking through the city, the Dayton Million Moms March had a moment of silence for recent victims of gun violence, including a 13-month-old boy who was shot and killed in Dayton earlier this year.
On a rainy, chilly Mother's Day, these families are marching through Dayton, carrying messages which say they've had enough of the gun violence.
Innocent people are getting killed from guns. Innocent children are getting killed. We've had shootings on the street of Dayton for innocent kids.
It's an issue which hits close to home for Carmen Jackson. She lost her 31-year-old son, Dante Edwards, to gun violence 10 years ago. Like others on this walk, she's hoping other moms won't have to spend Mother's Day mourning the shooting death of a loved one.
We don't want to see our children dying anymore. So this actually is in the spirit of Mother's Day.
Organizers say they were moved to begin this walk after a child was killed in a Dayton shooting. Back on January 14th, 13-month-old Elijah Johnson was killed after he was shot on Arlene Avenue. 2 men were arrested in connection with that shooting. Now, this group is hoping to raise awareness about responsible gun ownership so others won't have to suffer.
The march is for anyone. It's for mothers, fathers, parents, individuals who just want to make a difference.
And I believe we need to teach our children at a young age that guns are dangerous and that guns are driven through negative emotions.
And this was the first year for that march here in Dayton, but organizers are hoping this will continue to grow. Hopefully this will be an annual event, they say, can help mothers and families begin that healing process after a loss. Reporting live in Dayton, Robert Lowry, 2 News, working for you.